Welcome to World of Monsters. I'm Monster Master Arthur, and welcome to Movie Monster Reviews, where we review the monsters, not the movies. And today, yes, today we'll be talking about the great, the only Gojira, or Godzilla, a linguistic play on words of gorilla and kujira, where gorilla means gorilla, and kujira means whale. King of monsters? Arguably. But let's get started. As usual, we're gonna begin deep on this monster. So great monster, so great that I've got to honor it. That's right, Monsterites, it may get a little hot in here, but nothing compared to how hot this titanic creature is. So let's get digging. As usual, we always start with the movies. And with Gojira, there are so many, including the upcoming Godzilla of 2019, King of the Monsters. Similar titling to the first American edited version of Gojira. So I'm not gonna take your time by going into each movie, which you're probably aware of, but if you do wanna know all the Godzilla movies and variations, do see my video covering all the Godzillas and variations, and the movie titles and dates. Gojira, or Godzilla, which I will be referring to interchangeably, has been featured in video games, novels, comic books, and television shows, among, of course, the over 30 movies. And by the way, a Batman vs. Godzilla was discussed, though never finally produced, though yet a comic series of Godzilla battling the Avengers was. Interesting. But now let's jump into the original Gojira, which was the actual original name, not Godzilla, Gojira of 1954. Gojira was a production of Ishiro Honda's. It was a tokusatsu production, meaning special filming, which refers to a film that greatly uses special effects, that style of movie. And so the creation of Godzilla was mainly created by Ishiro Honda, not the founder of Honda, the car company, but a Japanese film director, producer, screenwriter, editor, and ex-soldier who unfortunately has left us at the age of 81 in 1993. And as you watch this, keep his words in mind. Monsters are born too tall, too strong, too heavy. That is their tragedy. And you can see this phrase reflected with the personality and character that each kaiju daikaiju held. And we gotta get this out of the way. There is a story that Gojira was actually the nickname of a rather large or overweight stagehand or propman at Toho Studio. But the true conceptual inspiration behind Gojira was quite a bit more grim. It all started at the end of World War II, 1954, when a US hydrogen bomb was tested in the Pacific. And it didn't go quite as planned, and the radiation fallout spanned 1 million square miles, sending contaminated fish and ships of sick crew members to shore, with radiation levels 5 times the norm. And that's right, I said ships. Not just the well-known Lucky Dragon 5.
Ship after ship arrived at the base with sick crews.
The radiation spanned over islands, polluting the local agriculture and population. The fear of massive bomb explosions was alive again, and it's this surge that gave birth to a titanic monster within the depths of the Pacific Ocean. A more composed and coherent face was placed onto the mushroom-shaped destroyer, invoking a new kind of terror in the hearts of the audience. Opposed to Asia's Lucky Dragon, this took the appearance of a twisted, very unlucky, dark, dragon dinosaur reptilian form. It was a representation of all the angry spirits of all the lost Japanese soldiers of World War II. Eventually, the film made it to the US, where it was re-edited and during a mistranslation was renamed as Godzilla. And I repeat, mistranslation, with the addition of King of the Monsters, forever proclaiming it as humanity's, or one of humanity's, biggest creature threats. So if you're a true fan, you better be calling it Gojira. But wait, this wasn't the only sole inspiration behind Gojira. Because in 1953, The Beast from 20,000 Fathoms featured a creation by Ray Harryhausen. It was a prehistoric dinosaur that was awakened by a nuclear bomb. Sound familiar? This is when Tanaka's Japanese studio took the idea and with a well-known sci-fi writer wrote a knockoff screenplay which temporarily held a very similar title, but which definitely scored much higher in the box office. Now let's touch upon the actual creature creation, what we see on a big screen. After filming began, Honda still did not even know exactly what the creature would look like. The earliest placeholder conception was that of a strange giant octopus. The modeling department made 3 attempts before coming up with a final design, from being a large-headed fishy creature to a warty beast, and then finally, with a more organized reptilian sort of pattern of bumps, the Gojira design was approved. It's said that the creation of the bumps themselves was to suggest the type of scars that radiation survivors had from previous tragedies. And now instead of making Godzilla tiny, as was the leading way of creating monsters for movies at the time using stop motion, instead he stayed our size and everything around him became smaller, making him a true thunderous lizard. Don't take lizard for certain just yet. We'll discuss that later in the video. So the buildings, the environment, was substantially decreased in size, and Gojira became a costume for one of the actors, Haruo Nakajima, for 12 consecutive films. Well done, Master Nakajima, whose history in judo made this creature come to life. Our beloved Haruo, who actually had just died in August of this year, 2017, at the age of 88. The mouth was mechanically operated, and the actor's vision was extremely limited. There were actually 4 small eye holes on Gojira's neck, again making for very harsh acting conditions, with the addition that the suit was becoming over 200 pounds. Hence, Katsumi Tezuka became Gojira's alternating actor, and who is still with us to this day at 105 years old. Keep eating that healthy Japanese food. And in time, the suit was obviously remade. But this all made for a slow, hulking giant monster, which corresponded nicely with the 1950s conception of dinosaurs as being sluggish and encumbered by their heavy weight and size. The movie cost over 200 times, I said 200 times, the average movie that was being produced in Japan, but quickly became a monstrous blockbuster success. So before we go off into the deep end of what Godzilla actually is and where it came from, let's recap real quick how Godzilla was presented to us first. And again, it was in 1954 when a US hydrogen bomb testing gave wake to a preserved gigantic bipedal dinosaur-like creature. At 50 meters tall, it emerged from the ocean onto Japanese soils and wreaked havoc. During a conference, Professor Kyohei Yamane brought up the fact that the Earth is still holding many mysteries. And might I say, great little shout out to the Yeti there, Professor Yamane. A trilobite was found in the footprint of the great beast, hinting at the age it derived from. And finally, the great Gojira, and spoilers, if you haven't seen the original movie, stop now, skip a little forward a few seconds. I'm giving you the time. Okay, the great beast was killed by a secret weapon known as the Oxygen Destroyer, which was invented by Dr. Daisuke, and it was a nice little reference to Einstein and to what he should have done, keeping the notes of creating the atom bomb a secret. Though of course not the sacrificing himself part, as the doctor character in the movie had. So now that we know how originally Godzilla came to us, how it was presented to us, let's now look at the history, the origin of Godzilla, and take a look at its personality and the character of this creature. As original movies progressed, Godzilla's motivation for human destruction decreased and more or less changed course onto other kaiju, daikaiju, or gigantic creatures. Godzilla never expressed a particular allegiance with humanity, but rather a nonchalant attitude that would still lead to the destruction of large portions of a city. This may simply be a territorial attitude, possibly treating humans as a small, insignificant creature in its area. Gojira did, in fact, once or so display interest in a human being. And that was when Gojira actually replaced the role of King Kong, which happened in the movie Godzilla vs. the Sea Monster, where Godzilla did indeed display some of the characteristics of King Kong. Now the original origin, and you know how big this topic can be and is just because of the variety of movies out there. A couple movies state that Gojira existed before the age of dinosaurs, but it's unclear how far prior. Another movie, Godzilla vs. King Ghidorah, states that it's the last remaining Godzillasaurus dinosaur that had survived on an island. Depending on which specific movie lore you want to follow, the differences basically go after these descriptions with varying levels of mutation and determination on the species type. There is the notion that Godzilla always had this form in enormous size, hence Godzillasaurus, the fictional dinosaur, though radiation slightly mutated it. Then there's a notion that the fallout radiation totally mutated it, hence Zilla, from a modern-day marine iguana, or some other creature, as in the mystery of Shin Godzilla, which made mention of a creature that fed on the nuclear waste of the 1950s and was mutated into this fast-evolving monster. There are also many theories around this, such as the first form being in tadpole form, and on and on. What do you guys think is the real origin, or which path do you go down in believing Godzilla's origin is? And that's an important topic, especially going into the next section, which is ecology and location. What was or is the Godzilla-type creature's natural ecology, if it ever had one? If Godzilla is a theropod dinosaur species, then the original ecology would be assumed to be the Jurassic to Cretaceous prehistoric periods, on tropical lands full of vegetation and oxygen. And that's just going off the idea that it may be a theropod. The next question is, what would it eat? What does Godzilla eat? Well, we know that actually, for the most part, it feeds on radiation, though Junior Godzilla has been seen feeding on plants and animals. But as you look at the teeth, the fangs of Gojira, yes, they're fangs. They appear more carnivorous in nature. But I'd say if they were more uniform, as in iguanas for instance, a possibility could easily be that Gojira is omnivorous. In the 1998 American version movie of it, or something similar to Gojira, it is shown to have a big appetite for fish. But again, this version is often disregarded, being seen as Zilla, not Godzilla, a separate kind of creature that we see again later in a Japanese Godzilla movie. So, it's up to you if you want to consider Zilla part of the Gojira universe or not, and also if you want to learn more about Zilla of the 1998 United States Godzilla, let me know and I'll make a separate video about that one. Oh, there's so much more to discuss about our lumpy titanic friend, such as abilities and strengths and anatomical details. Power level, please proceed to part 2 now.